Dear students, today we will discuss on topic mathematics in daily life. In that we will solve a few questions of my practice time 1. Here the question number 3 is that find the profit or loss and its amount in the following cases. Here the item is given mixer grinder. Okay, so the cost price of mixer grinder is rupees 5000 and the selling price of mixer grinder is rupees 6000. Now we have to find out the profit or loss. According to the question, the cost price of mixer grinder is rupees 5000 and the selling price of mixer grinder is rupees 6000. So here we can clearly see that the selling price of mixer grinder is greater than the cost price of mixer grinder, right? So here selling price is greater than cost price, so in that condition there is profit. So profit is equal to SP minus CP. Here we will subtract the cost price from the selling price, right? So 6000 minus 5000 is equal to 1000. So there is a profit of rupees 1000. So the answer is the amount of profit is rupees 1000. Right? Next question. Another item is given, oven. Okay, so the cost price of oven is rupees 7500 and the selling price of oven is rupees 5200. So we have to find out the profit or loss. Dear students, according to the question, the cost price of oven is rupees 7500 and the selling price of oven is rupees 5200. So we can clearly see here that the cost price of oven is greater than the selling price of oven, right? So here CP is greater than the SP. So in that condition, there is a loss. So loss is equal to CP minus SP. Now here we will subtract selling price from the cost price, right? So here 0 minus 0 will be 0 and again 0 minus 0 will be 0. Then 5 minus 2 will be 3 and 7 minus 5 will be 2. So there is a loss of rupees 2300, right? So the answer is the amount of loss is equal to rupees 2300. Next question. Here the item is music system. Okay, so the cost price of music system is rupees 3000 and the selling price of music system is rupees 2550. So we have to again calculate the profit or loss. Okay, so according to the question, we know that the cost price of music system is rupees 3000 and the selling price of music system is rupees 2550, right? So we can compare and we can clearly see here that which is greater? Yes, the cost price of music system is greater than the selling price of music system. So in that condition, again there is loss. So loss is equal to CP minus SP. Now we will put the value of CP and SP. So now here we will subtract. Here we will subtract selling price from the cost price, right? So here 0 minus 0 will be 0. Then we cannot subtract 5 from 0. So we need to take borrow. So after taking borrow, we have here 10. So 10 minus 5 will be 5. So after returning the borrow, we have 9 here. So 9 minus 5 will be 4. Then again, we have to return borrow here. After returning the borrow, there is 2. So 2 minus 2 will be 0. So there is a loss of rupees 450. So the amount of loss is rupees 450. This is the answer. Now question number 4. The question number 4 is that Raj bought pants for rupees 130 a dozen and he sold it for rupees 20 each. So what was his profit? Dear students, look at the question carefully, that what information is given here, right? So Raj bought pens. That means the cost price of a dozen pen is rupees 130. Okay, the cost price of one dozen pen is rupees 130. Here it is given, and the selling price. Okay, here it is given the selling price of one pen. Right, here it is given the selling price of one pen. So what we have to find out? We have to find out the profit. So for that, what we will do? First, we know that according to the question, the cost price of one dozen pens is equal to rupees 130, and the selling price of one pen is equal to rupees 20. So what we'll have to find out first? We'll have to find out the selling price of one dozen pen, right? We have to find out the selling price of one dozen pen. For that, what we will do? For that, we will multiply. Okay, what we will multiply? We will multiply 20 by 12. Why so? Because we know that the cost price of one pen is equal to the selling price. Okay, the selling price of one pen is equal to rupees 20. Okay, therefore the selling price of 12 pen, okay, is equal to what? So we will multiply 20 into 12 here. Why 12 here? Because one dozen is equal to 12 item, right? So here 20 multiplied by 12, so here 2 zeros are 0 and 2 twos are 4, 1 0 is a 0, 1 2 is a 2. Now we will add this, so 0 0 here, 4 plus 0 4 and 2 here, so 240. So what is here 240, dear students? Yes, what is 240 here? Rupees 240 is the selling price of the one dozen pen, right? So here in that condition, we can see that the selling price is greater than the cost price, because cost price of one dozen pen is rupees 130 and the selling price of one dozen pen is rupees 240. So in that condition, there is profit. Okay, so profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. So now we will subtract cost price from the selling price. So here 0 minus 0 will be 0, and 4 minus 3 will be 1, and 2 minus 1 will be 1. So there is profit of rupees 110, right? So the profit was rupees 110. Now question number 5. James sold his piano for rupees 40,000. He had bought the piano for rupees 67,500. Find the loss incurred by James. So here you can see, students, that he had bought the piano for rupees 67,500. That means the cost price of piano is rupees 67,500, and James sold his piano for rupees 40,000. That means the selling price of piano is rupees 40,000, right? So according to the question, it is given that the cost price of piano is rupees 67,500 and the selling price of piano is rupees 40,000. So in that condition, we can clearly see that the cost price is greater than the selling price. Okay, so in that condition, there is loss, right? So loss is equal to CP minus SP. So again, we will subtract selling price from the cost price, right? So 0 minus 0 will be 0, then 0 minus 0 will be 0, then 5 minus 0 will be 5, then 7 minus 0 will be 7, and 6 minus 4 will be 2. So there is a loss of rupees 27,500. Okay, so rupees 27,500 loss incurred by James, right? Now next question. Nisha bought a LED TV for rupees 22,780 and sold it for rupees 21,954. What is her profit or loss? Yes, dear students, we have to calculate again the profit or loss. Okay, so here we can see that Nisha bought LED TV for rupees 22,780 and sold. So it is very clear that the cost price of LED TV is ₹22,780 and the selling price of LED TV is ₹21,954. Let's solve this. It is given according to the question. The cost price of LED TV is ₹22,780 and the selling price of LED TV is ₹21,954. So here we can clearly see that the cost price of LED TV is greater than the selling price of LED TV, right? In that condition, there is loss. So loss is equal to again CP minus SP. So here we will subtract selling price from the cost price, right? So here we can see here, we cannot subtract 4 from 0, right? So we need to take borrow. Okay, so after taking borrow, it is 10. Okay, so now 10 minus 4 will be 6, right? So after returning the borrow, there is 7. So 7 minus 5, 7 minus 5 will be 2, right? Now we cannot subtract 9 from 7. So again, we need to take borrow. After taking borrow, we have 17. So 17 minus 9 will be 8. Right? After returning the borrow, there is 1. So 1 minus 1, okay, is equal to 0, and 2 minus 2 will be 0. So there is a loss of ₹826, right? Now we will solve few questions of my practice time 2. Find the cost price. Here the selling price is ₹762.50 and profit is ₹80.75. So we have to find out the cost price. SP is equal to ₹762.50 and profit is ₹80.75. In that condition, the cost price is equal to selling price minus gain or profit, right? So here we will subtract the gain from the selling price. So here we cannot subtract 5 from 0. So we need to take borrow. Okay, after taking borrow, it is 10. So 10 minus 5 will be 5. Then after returning the borrow, there is 4. So again, we cannot subtract 7 from 4. Okay, so again we need to take borrow. After taking borrow, it is 14. So 14 minus 7 will be 7. Then after returning the borrow, there is 1. So 1 minus 0 will be 1. Then again we cannot subtract 8 from 6. So we need to take borrow. So here after taking borrow, it is 16. So 16 minus 8 will be 8. Then again after returning the borrow, there is 6 instead of 7. So 6 minus 0 will be 6. So the cost price is ₹681.75, right? Next question number B. Selling price is equal to ₹489.75 and loss is equal to ₹78.50. So what is the cost price? Here it is given that SP is equal to ₹489.75 and loss is equal to ₹78.50, right? So in that condition, cost price is equal to selling price plus loss. In terms of loss, the cost price is equal to selling price plus loss. So we have to add both this amount. Okay. Now we will add loss and selling price. So 5 plus 0 will be 5. Then 7 plus 5 will be 12. So 12 we will write 2 here and 1 carry over here. So 9 plus 1 will be 10 and 10 plus 8 will be 18. So we will write 8 here and 1 carry over here, right? So here 1 plus 8 is equal to 9 and 9 plus 7 will be 16. 16 we will write 6 here and 1 carry over here. So 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. So the cost price is rupees 568.25 paise. Dear students, you will have to solve all these sums in your mathematics notebook, right? Thank you.